So those are some of the things. We've sponsored other
activities. I love that idea, by the way.
Yeah, I love that, too.
I think that sounds like a lot of fun.
Taking some girl on a test drive.
It got attention all day long. And there were a lot of people. You know, we probably had, you know, 80 or 100 folks who actually participated, and they all had a blast.
And did anyone find love?
Yeah, we actually did have a few folks that said that they were going to go on dates afterward. And then we had a few people that said, you know what, we don't care, because we got down to the tail end of the, and we didn't have like male-male matches or female-female matches or trans matches to make. And they said, you know what, we don't care. We just want to network with one another. This
Let's
is so much fun.
Friend.
Yeah, so they treated it that way. And then we've done things like with affirmations. Again, they do a youth prom.
Right.
And what does every teenager want? They want to arrive at prom in a hot car, you know, so we've sent, you know, Escalade hybrids and Corvettes and Camaros to the youth prom so they could at least have their picture made in it and put it up in their locker when they get back to school to make it look like they arrived in a hot car.
That sounds pretty hot. Now, Daryl, you know, obviously HRC is working on ensuring that more and more companies are behaving in the way the GM is, and really thinking about their LGBT employees, being very inclusive and trying to, you know, really push the limits. So with a company that, you know, sounds like it's doing a really good job like GM is, what can they do even better?
Well, aside from letting me take a test drive in the Escalade Hybrid, there are a couple of things that HRC is really working on actively to put some flesh on the bones of these policies that companies like GM and others have put in place. So what we're finding is that in some cases, employees, even though they work at these companies, may or may not have the same experience across the board.
Right.
And we are developing a climate assessment tool that will be available in the next couple of months. It is the result of a couple of years of research that we've done with 14 focus groups across the country, from the South to you know, all different kinds of geographic areas, racial, ethnic, gender diversity, union, non-union, blue-collar, white-collar workers. And we've done a national poll that we'll be releasing, and we find that policies are extremely important, but ultimately only go so far. And what we're going to be doing in the next couple of months is working with companies to give them a short survey that they can send out to their LGBT employees to get a really good sense of what their day-to-day experience is like. And we'll be able to grade companies on that. Now, it's not going to be a public grade right at the beginning. It'll be
right.
Something that we just share with the companies directly so that they can work on the issues themselves. But we will also have a series of tools of sort of, you know, next step procedures and important things for companies to begin looking at in terms of really making the policies impact the day-to-day lives. And as Travis mentioned, we're raising the bar on the Corporate Equality Index, and so I think GM is in a really good position to maintain their 100% score.
And then there are companies like mine that are barely squeaking by, and
yeah,
we're going to get totally sucked.
Here's my question. How do we get companies to want to get rated by the HRC? How do we get companies to want to do this? To participate in a gay friendly world, you know? How can we make that seem appealing?
I think it's something that is there's a pretty solid couple of business reasons. I mean, the way that we recommend, the way that we approach companies is to point out to them why it's in their best interest, because you know, a lot of these policies and practices the companies are doing, they're great and they feel good, and you know, but we do have to be realistic about what these companies are really in business for, and that is
right.
to make money.
Right.
And so we look at you know, who are the competitors? I mean, there's so many companies now that have 100%, GM and the other two, Chrysler and Ford as well. But there are many other car companies that don't have that score yet. And so how do you
make that
point?
I can think of a couple that makes me sad.
Exactly. And you can sort of make the point, well, if an LGBT consumer has a choice, which many of them do, wouldn't they, you know, prefer to go to a company like GM rather than one that doesn't have the inclusive policies that GM does? And then, you know, you just simply make a case that they're losing money by really falling behind the rest of the pack.
Yeah, my friends Joe and Joe over at GayWheels.com, they actually are always, because there's a particular car company I like, and they're like, Romain, they don't do well with the gays. And I'm like, oh, it makes my heart cry. But at the same time, you know, they're right. And, you know, as a community, we really should be supporting the companies that are standing by us and are supporting us. And, you know, I like that they guilt me on that.
Thank you very much. And absolutely. Right now, at a time of economic downturn, it's more important than ever. And the thing to remember is that companies like ours turn and funnel that money right back into the community.
Right.
And we have put a lot of our foundation giving on hold right now until the financial situation turns around. So the more sales we make, you know, the more we're able to turn around and put it right back into the community. And Joe LaMoralia over at GayWheels.com,
love him,
has just done a new interesting study on LGBT trends in automotive.
Yep.
That does demonstrate a lot of loyalty to these brands that have been very gay friendly. And like, for example, Saab, the average Saab driver is 18 times more likely to be gay than the average population.
I believe that. I have a gay brother-in-law who totally is a Saab driver.
Yeah, so there's a lot of loyalty in those areas.
Yeah. All right, let's go to the phone real quick because we have a question for Travis. Trucker James, you're on the line.
Thanks, Romain. Travis, I have a question for you. Both my parents retired from GM, and I actually fell away from the brand a few years ago. You know, in a better economic time, because I know that niche marketing is you know, not something you want to put your money into right now. As you know, Ford, you know, sort of bowed down to pressure from the right wing and pulled their ads from The Advocate a few years back. Other than your one Cadillac ad that was sort of GLBT focused, are you planning on entering, you know, more, you know, the standard media outlets of print and commercials in the future for GLBT?
Like Derek and Romain.
Saab and Cadillac all have done quite a bit of LGBT advertising. Now, the only same-sex imagery advertising that we've done has been with Cadillac, but we've put other ads, including some pretty racy ones with Saab that says, like with the convertible that says versatile tops and things along those lines.
Ooh, I think that sounds hot. I like it.
Yeah. Some really cute puns. I think some of those were on GayWheels.com for a while, based out of Canada. So we've done some pretty fun stuff. And then I don't know if some of you saw The Road to Success, which was on Logo, which profiled four successful LGBT entrepreneurs. And it was sponsored by the Cadillac CTS. So it was kind of an interesting way to say, hey, you know, 15-second spot on the CTS, and then it launches into, you know, a high profile within the community that just celebrates LGBT success. So we are continuing to look for interesting ways, both in advertising and in public relations outreach, to go direct to consumers.
All right, cool.
What about changing
Trucker
the
James,
name of the
call.
Brand to Cadillac, like C-A-T-T-Y, like... Or
Cadillac.
I think you should submit some proposals.
If you need a new head of marketing, you let me know.
And Nezapor, you crack me up. All right. Well, listen, Travis, thank you so much for coming on and telling us more about what General Motors is doing. We really appreciate your time. And I got to say, I really, really think what you guys are doing at GM for the LGBT community is phenomenal. And I hope you'll continue to do even more.
I think we need to get a test drive Camaro in your driveway.
Oh, hey, yeah. I would drive it.
You just let me know. I'll show up with the keys myself.
Well, shit, boo, I'm there. You don't have to ask me twice. I drive a really old Chevy Cavalier.
Excellent.
And it's old. And I keep begging my girlfriend to let me buy a new car. So we'll talk. And Daryl, thank you so much for joining us and talking about all the great work that HRC is doing around the Corporate Equality Index. And, you know, for pointing out, you know, these great companies like GM that are actually actively out there scoring perfect 100 scores. If only I could get SiriusXM to do the same thing, I would be the happiest girl in the whole wide world.
We'll work on it with you, and thank you very much for the opportunity.
Absolutely. Thank you, gentlemen. We've got more phone calls and more fun coming up next.